In this Programming for Artists tutorial, I'm going to show you the basics of how to use the p5.js web editor. The p5.js web editor is really great because you can get started with creative coding with just a web browser and internet access. So let's see what we have here. Over on the left, there is a sketch.js that has some code over it. And then on the right, there's a preview box that has nothing. If we press this play button up at the top left, suddenly on the preview, we have a square. Why do we have a square? Let's look at the code. Over here it says create canvas 400, 400. That means that it's creating a canvas 400 by 400. But why is it gray? Well, there's a clue here. It says background 220. So we're going to get into all of these functions later in the course, but let's just start by changing a few numbers. What if I change the first 400 to 300? Well, nothing happens. That's because I need to run this sketch again. So if I press the play button again, suddenly this is now 300 pixels wide and 400 pixels tall. What if I change background? If I make this 20, again, nothing happens, but I can press play and suddenly it becomes black. So this is starting to give us a clue to what these different functions are doing. One nice thing that you can do is click auto refresh. That way, if I type in a number, here under background, it automatically changes. Or if I type in here and I make this 400 by 400, it updates. So over here we have our code and on the right we have preview. So using this auto refresh checkmark can be really great because we can see what's going on. So I'm going to walk you through the example on the p5.js website so we can just see how this might work. So let's go ahead and add a bit of background color to our image. So I can type in some extra colors and suddenly we have a yellow background. So if you type in a single number for a background in p5.js, you get a grayscale. If you type in three numbers, you get red, green, blue. So if I type in zero here for the red, suddenly it's going to be very green. I'll go back to, now we have a nice yellow color. And underneath this, I'm going to type ellipse, parentheses 50, comma 50, comma 80, comma 80, close parentheses, semicolon. This example is directly from the p5.js website, and it's drawn an ellipse 50 pixels in, 50 pixels down, 80 by 80. We'll cover this more in depth, but 00 is in the top left corner, and it counts this way in the x direction and this way in the y direction. So let's change a few things. If I make this 80 also, suddenly the ellipse moves over. I could also make it have different sizes here if you want to make it more egg shape. But what's really great is if I type in a variable that's built into p5.js, I can type mouseX. And suddenly now the ellipse follows my mouse if I hover my mouse over the square here. And then for the Y value, I can type mouseY. And now the ellipse follows my mouse. How do I know which ones I can type in? If we look at the reference page of p5.js, we can see mouse X and mouse Y right here. We can also see this other one, mouse is pressed. And if you click on these, you'll get to see some information. And we'll cover more about this later. Right now, we're just focusing on the web editor. So here I have my web editor program right here, and I'm moving the circle around with my mouse. Now, how do I save or share this program to edit later? Well, what I need to do is come up here to File and Save, but I need to be logged in. So if you want to save your sketch, you need to log in or sign up. So you can go ahead and click on the login button here, and then you can log in with GitHub or log in with Google, or you can set up an account with p5.js. So now that I'm logged in, I can File, Save. And it gives us a name automatically, which is great because it's better than untitled, but it's best to name this. So I'll click up in the top left and I'll say editor demo. So let's do a few more things to this. Remember that if mouse is pressed, so let's go. Now it seems like it's the same, but now we have an if mouse is pressed, it fills it as black. So it uses fill zero if the mouse is pressed, but if it's white, that means the mouse isn't pressed. And we can do one more fun thing. We can go ahead and move this background function up under create canvas. And now, as I move my mouse around, it keeps drawing because it's not redrawing the background. And then I can hold my mouse button down and draw black. Let go of my mouse button, hold the mouse button. Now let's say we want to share this sketch with all of our friends. What we can do is we can go to File, Save, and then we can go to File, Share. And there's a few different ways that you can share. You can embed this in an iframe, so you can embed this on your website. You can make it full screen, or you can go to the editor. So let's click on full screen. And then right here, we have this in the browser. So you can copy this URL, and then you can see the sketch as well. I'm going to put this URL in the description of the video. So hopefully you can use the p5.js web editor to start coding in p5.js. Happy programming.